Hi guys, FlightScar here. Today I'm going to show you a mod that I've created. It is Workshop Rotation. It is for the Xbox One and it allows you to rotate settlement objects on a different axis instead of the standard Z-axis. So I'll just unpause here and we'll get started. First thing, after downloading the mod, you will come into Workshop mode and choose special, and you will find the workshop rotate helper in special. If you just place that, and you'll get a pop-up. It's currently disabled, and all you have to do is click enable. And in here, you can change the step rotation. This roughly translates to degrees, so in here, you can do 0.1, 0.5, and it kind of gets more drastic as you go up to a whole 90 degrees. Just for now, we'll set it to 10 and then we'll click done and we'll just cancel that out. So we can actually disable and change the step rotation here, but we will just click cancel and just leave it as it is. And first, I'll show you the most basic thing we can do with this. If we come into floors, got a wooden floor, if I place it down, I am greeted with this box. I'm just gonna click done for now just to get rid of the extra one. So we've got a standard floor, and if I click on it again, I'm greeted with the box again, and I can choose which axis I want to change it to and also change the amount. So I'm gonna pick X, and it you can see that the current step rotation is 10, and I just want to increase it like the X axis by 10. So if I click the plus, we can see right, this sometimes happens. It's due to the game not knowing what to do. This has also happened with different mods, but if you just place the item down and then reselect it, just click done. Like you can just move it around as you would. So if I just put that down, you can see that our floor is now at roughly 10 degrees. And what we can do is, I'm too close to the house. Just click done again. Move away from the house. We actually can snap the floors together still. So we've kind of made it a little ramp. If we just click on the object that we want and choose a different axis, if I want to change this, I can kind of again just click it and it'll stay in place. So we've now rotated the floor. This does work for most objects. So if I come into the fridge, I can place the fridge down and I can tilt it over. As you can see, I've got the object still there because I've just placed it and obviously haven't cancelled out the existing one, so I could place another one. But we've got our fridge at a nice angle, and I'm just gonna knock it over a bit. We can rotate it as we wish. All right. So one thing to be wary of is when you do want to turn yourself around, the axis is now messed up, so this will rotate very oddly. So as you can see, if I do this, this is because we've adjusted the X and Y on it. There's not really much we can do with that, but this will allow you to place stuff down however you want. And finally, once you're happy with what you've got, you can just click on the helper again, click disable, click cancel, just place it down, and now it's not actually active. And you can also disable it just by scrapping the helper. And that just about covers it. you can do quite a bit with this. Hopefully it is useful. And like I said, there's only one issue that I've found, and that's where the item tries to snap everywhere. But if you can get it placed down, you can then change it as you want once you pick it back up. Thanks, guys.